Hi guys, welcome back again to my YouTube channel. So as in the previous video, I have promised you guys to upload a review on Canon Day Super 6 Evo. So here is the review, and this review is totally based on the riding experience plus the quality of the bicycle, which is top notch. So here we go.
Hello, I have been riding the Triban 500 for around 4 years now, and I recently upgraded to Cannondale Super 6 Evo. My primary usage has been traveling through the mountains. I have done parts of Uttarakhand, Ladakh, Spiti, etc. on this. This has been with or without luggage, solo, in a group, and in various different ways on various different routes. So this has been a very much used cycle for me, which has traveled with me through various terrains and through various styles of riding. My decision to buy this new bike, the Cannondale, was prompted by my recent activities in and around Gwalior, which is my hometown. Basically, most of the roads here are flat, so we have no climbs etc. over here. So I, due to the lockdown, was able to ride a lot on flat roads, and I previously had little experience in doing that, so my speeds were quite less on flat roads. But now I thought that maybe I'm improving, so I should invest in a cycle which is better for traveling faster on flatter roads, and also better for traveling on climbs. So which is why this choice, this was supposed to be an all-rounder sort of a choice for me. So in this video, I just want to highlight some of the differences which I felt during the first three rides. My each ride, daily rides, are like 50 to 70 kilometers in length, so, and average around 30-32 kmph total. So I wanted to compare the changes which I felt between these two bikes. For me, the change has been complete, because everything, right from the frame, the handle, wheels, saddle, pedals, gear shifters, everything has been different and upgraded in sort of a way on this bike. The frame is on this is aluminium, on that is carbon. The wheels are better, the hubs are better. There's a Shimano 105 gear set on this, complete with brake levers etc. And the pedals are clipless, as were on this. I recently changed this to normal ones, but these are supposed to be better pedals. I think the handle is better. The saddle is quite different. It's quite different from the one which I'm used to. This is the stock saddle on the Triban which came with the bike, and this is the stock one here. I mostly felt in my first three rides, that is around 200 kilometers of distance which I have done on this one, that for a layman, for an enthusiast like me, this bike is around 2 to 3 kmph faster on an average for me. Like, I don't know if my skills are limited to that, or if my current stamina is limited to that, but that is what the result I have got. I expect it to increase with time as I get more comfortable with this setup, because the geometry is different. This was more of a relaxed geometry. This is slightly more of a stretch for me if I want to sit. So it's not that comfortable, but yeah, it's good. I think I'll be able to get used to it. So right now it's difficult for me to put down power as easily on this, but it's mostly being done. The primary change is the gear shifting. For one of the primary changes is the gear shifting, which is super smooth on this. I had a micro shift system. The micro shift system is more of a rudimentary sort of a thing. You have to click on the gear shifter pedal, and it takes time, and you have to hear, listen to the sound of the gear shifting, and then you can continue pedaling. But over here it's like quick, so you press the shifter and it's like done. So that was a major change for me. The carbon frame is super comfortable, so all the bumps on the road and that feel, the rough feel of the concrete roads, is completely gone. I hardly feel any more of that. Thirdly, the chain on this one got out of the ring quite easily, so I had to stop at times, you know, once every two or three rides, and get it up, set up again. On this one I haven't had any issue, even though I've been riding it rougher than this one. The saddle is longer and thinner on this one, so that was sort of an issue for me for the first two rides, but then I sort of adjusted the angle of that, so that is now much better. Apart from that, I think that I will only be able to understand this bike a lot more once I have ridden it like around 500-600 kilometers, when I get properly comfortable with it. But right now all I can say is, from a layman, from an enthusiast point of view, from someone who doesn't have any race experience or a lot of experience in riding cycles, I can say that if I invested an additional amount of money in addition to this, to upgrade to this, I got flatly, I got 2 to 3 kmph of increase in my average speeds. That's it. And plus I got an increase in comfort, and I got an easier to extract performance because of the gear shifting, because of the better pedals, and because of the overall better position, I got an easier to extract performance. On this, things were like slightly harder. On this, things are slightly easier. So I'll be able to get better speeds for slightly lesser effort. But I think that as time will progress, I think this is mid-June right now, I am expecting that I'll be able to do around 500 kilometers more till the end of the month if situation is normal as it is right now. So I'll be able to understand this one better, and then maybe we can do another review, a long, slightly longer term review of how this bike performs.